people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans ami canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no chaneru ni yokoso. I hope you're doing fine today. This is another day, another week, and another video of me. And even more, it's Christmas week. Today, I really wanted to make it special because I think so much bigger in 2020, and it's just a time for me to kind of reflect on what I've learned for those past 5 years and share with you my main tips on to how to be confident. And we're talking about the clothes, we're talking about the confidence, but we're talking about everything around it. When you are confident, you attract the right people to you. You literally find yourself being surrounded by genuine people and people that are as confident as you. For me, a way to literally showcase how every single thing starts with you. Start with your own confidence, because without it, you can't do anything else. Building a business, having a family, finding the right person, I mean, all of that starts with having a lot more confidence. And let's just tackle it on the best way possible, and let's tackle 2020 the best way possible for that matter. So be weird, be strange, it's all about being good, but be yourself, because that's gonna be your way of being confident. When I say find your purpose, it's find your why. Going into 2020, whatever you do, it could be about the business, it could be about a relationship, it could be about finding the right person for you finally. It could be out of that, but if you don't have a specific goal, this is never gonna be a great way to start that. You know what I mean? Nobody is gonna come and tell you what you need to do. You being confused onto what you want to do, it's gonna make it even more confusing into feeling confident about it. And I say it again, it could be anything. It doesn't have to be you being the next Oprah. I mean, I want to be the next Oprah. Hopefully. Coming from a place of purpose literally feel and gives you so much more energy. It's not anybody else. This is you, and this is your goal, and this is your purpose. And yes, I'm being really on fire right now when I talk about it. The second thing I will talk here is the comparison. We need to stop that nonsense. Being on Instagram, being on social media, most of the time you're gonna find yourself comparing yourself again to other people. And this kind of negative self-talk that you're gonna have on yourself is gonna destroy your confidence. Take it as you being not good enough. And that's the reason why you're never gonna feel like you're good enough, because you're gonna spend hours, literally hours on Instagram, seeing other pictures and feeling like you want to be like them. If you need to unfollow people that just don't inspire you, I mean, just do it. At some point, I had to spend less time on Instagram. At the end of the day, the only person you need to compare yourself with is you. And being the best version of yourself. And if you need to compare yourself, are all part of a group of friends. And women, we have it harder. I don't know why, I feel like energy between guys, they kind of see that comparison and being challenged by it and not feeling bad about themselves. But us as women feel that jealousy and that envy and be like, no, I want to be better than her, and just feeling bad about ourselves. What you need to understand is that outside of social media, you being in a group of friends, if you feel that, take that energy and transform it. You're the alchemist here. Take that energy back, transform it, and use it to your own advantage. And that means use it to make yourself being better about yourself. Being my own alchemist, because I need to use that energy and I need to just bring some great energy about myself. And again, if you need to compare yourself, use that energy, transform it, be your own alchemist, and beat it and be the best version of yourself. First sign. Get onto the solutions. When you have a problem arising, instead of a little bit defeated about it, focus on the solutions, because at the end of the day, life happens. This is a part of living. You're always gonna have problems, you're always gonna have issues, you're always gonna have a next challenge. And that's a way for you to better at doing them, at overcoming them, and at being a stronger leader. Being tested by the universe and by God. All these challenges are there to make you be a stronger person. Leader, not leader, just a stronger person. When you have problems arising, take them as another challenge, as another test. And I remember like 5 years from now, the way that I would struggle finding solutions to my problem. And right about now, I can say that I'm like literally not being affected by anything that could happen to me. No, at all. I'm still a human being. But what I can say for me for now is how to focus on the solution. Always, always complaining about the problems. Nobody is gonna fix it for you. It's not gonna get fixed by itself, but you need to take actions yourself. The more you're gonna do it, the more you're gonna feel freaking confident about it. When I'm gonna be ready to share it, I will share it. But today I'm still alive and I'm gonna do everything that I need to do to get to my goals. Focus on the solution and solutions only. Is to be strange, to be weird, to be unique, because that's gonna be your magic. That's gonna be your strengths. And let me explain here. When you're playing to your own strengths, this is when you're getting so much more confident, because if you compare yourself to somebody else, you don't know that person. You don't know that person's strength. Even worse if it's on social media, because at the end of the day, people are sharing just a part of their lives. So you can't even know what a person is literally going through in real life. For you, to be able to be you is to be able to focus on what is unique about you. So if you need to be weird, that means that maybe we need another weird person on this planet to literally shake it up a little bit more. Because look what happens. I mean, Trump, the end of the world, we're all gonna get killed at some point. I don't know. But what I can say here is you being weird, you being unique is the same thing. Battle for that for years and years and years. And I can say that I was the only different person. I could just say that I had my own way of thinking, I had my own way of dressing up, I had my own way of seeing the world and having my own perspective. But there was not the majority around me thinking the same way that I did. So because of that, I literally didn't feel as confident as I am now, because I felt like I had to literally imitate the other people because I had to belong to a certain group. And for it to be good for me, I had to be like them. I didn't want to be too different, but at the same time, there was that little voice telling me, just be yourself. And that little voice is there when you feel stuck, when you feel like you're not good, when you're not feeling good, and then when there's something missing, that little thing, this is when you and the real you is telling you, get back to be yourself. And right about soon to be coming the 2020 decade, another decade, I'm focusing on my own uniqueness. Courage. You have to have that courage to be you, because it's hard. Being social, belonging to a social group and wanting to belong to a social group, because we are human beings, makes it hard for us, because you have one part when you want to be yourself, but the other part because you hear whatever the society tells you about you being a certain way. Have two forces here that don't make it easy for you. Being able to understand other people without having to judge them. And for me, it's a good balance. So think about it. You know that all good saying, fake it until you make it. Yes, people. Because the more you're gonna fake it, the more you're gonna pretend that you are confident, the more it's gonna become a reality for you. And it's not about trying to shut away any bad emotions. I feel and believe that you need to work on those little bad emotions that you have. But the more you're gonna dwell on them, the more you're gonna get to the way where you're not gonna be feeling confident at all. Pretend that you feel good in order to feel better. In order to be successful, you need to live like you're already successful. That doesn't mean that literally spending $1,000 per month just for clothes, per se. I mean, successful has a different definition for everybody. It can mean like having a great family, or having the loved ones around you, or just having a lot of money. Successful has different meaning. You need to feel like you're already there, even if you're not there yet, because your thoughts are gonna follow your emotions. The more you're gonna do it, the more the universe is gonna respond to it in a really good and great manner. Everything is bad, everything is worse, we just see the bad side of it. The more you're gonna get stuck, the more difficult it's gonna be for you to get unstuck. If you need to post anything on your walls, on your room, you need to see that every single day until you believe it. And I'm telling you, every single day. If you need to do meditations, do them. If you need to have a journal and you need to write a lot of things for you to be able to feel better, do it as well. To push them, if you need to shake them a little bit. Having imposter syndrome is probably the worst thing ever, and we are suffering of it, or at least the majority of us. Every single day I wake up and wondering why I do what I do, be able to build my own dreams. But it's always advice telling me to keep pushing. Even when you feel discouraged, even when you feel like you're not good at all, believe me, keep pushing. You don't even realize what is gonna be at the end for you. Take action. We all know how fear could be paralyzing. It could take you to just get stuck there and not taking any actions. And the more you're gonna do it, the more these negative voices, they're gonna be stronger. But the other way can happen too. The more you're gonna take action, the more quiet they're gonna become. But you need to quiet them down. You need to shut them out. So hurry, because when you get out of your comfort zone, it's literally where you're feeling all the imposter syndrome happening, all the negative voices happening, like you're not good enough, you're not worth anything. Who are you to even do that? I mean, who are you? All these voices, they're gonna tell you, literally pouring you of all of those, you are nothing, you are not worth anything. When you get out of that comfort zone, it's gonna happen natural, and be like, you know what, I'm done with you. Be thankful for whatever the voice are gonna tell you and move on. When you take action, and even more so when you have a good result, that just makes you keep pushing even more. This is where the motivation starts even more. You're feeling energized. I mean, let's take dating for example. You staying at home, not doing anything because you're scared, but at the same time, you're looking to find a man. You're looking to find somebody to be with. Feel like you're ready to have a relationship. Staying at home is not gonna do anything. If you don't go out, if you don't expose yourself, you don't go to any bar, any type of social place where you can actually meet people, I mean, the guy is not gonna get to your place and just magically happen to just appear on your sofa. I'm just saying. It's to actually get that first step. And the first step usually requires you to actually talk to people, talk to friends, talk to other people, going to social events, and not staying stuck at home, not wanting to do anything. But at the same time, you're looking for somebody. I'm just saying, you need to take your own actions. And even after that, going on the first date, you ain't feeling it, and you feel like you maybe wasted your time. You didn't waste your time. It's not a failure. It's not at all. Because that first step actually made you to feel that you actually could meet people. So this is all related to you and how you see your own actions. The lesson you learned. That's the best way you have to take it. If you take it as just being a failure, you're gonna be unmotivated and you're gonna stop right there. Learners, how many bad experiences we can have as far as like dating, especially nowadays. Especially nowadays. Finding a lot of interesting people before getting to the most interesting people for you. If you make a business be a priority in your life, it's the same thing. Depending what you do, you need to go to networking events, you need to put yourself on social media probably much more. You're probably gonna have to be in front of the camera talking, even if you're feeling so scared of doing it. 10 years ago, I would never imagine myself being the camera right now talking to you in English, by the way. Not my first language. French is my first language. But even with it, I got to learn French, I got to learn English, I got to learn Spanish, Japanese, Korean, and a bit of Chinese. Taking actions start with you taking those actions, because it's not gonna happen if you stay in the sofa not doing anything. That's all I can say. Take it, think about it, think about it well. Be proud and take pride in whatever you're looking like, your appearance. Some people might say that it's superficial to think about what you look like and your appearance, but I grew up in a home where my mom made sure that we look a certain part whenever we would go to event, and even at home makes you look have no brain at all. Because if you feel like it's superficial, it's probably because there's a part of you where maybe you are superficial. When you're sure of yourself, when you know you have a brain, I mean, nobody can come and tell you things like that and you believing in it. Never. My mom could tell me stuff like that and maybe I'm gonna be affected and be like, Mom, you raised me that way. And anybody else coming at me right about now and telling me you are superficial, I'm probably gonna laugh at them. I use a soft power. I'm trying to get to a point. If there are people while trying to stop me from doing it, well, I'm gonna educate them the best way that I can. Being proud of in your appearance doesn't make you be superficial. It makes you be really loving about yourself. And I think it's a time for us, especially women, put ourselves first. We take care of everybody around ourselves. And we feel bad whenever we need to kind of focus on ourselves a little bit. And you're feeling bad. Because even when you feel like you're doing the right thing here, you're doing the right thing for others and you're doing the wrong thing for you. Even if you feel better, you're gonna feel better for a couple of hours probably. But then it's gonna go back at you. When you're gonna be by yourself, in your room or anywhere else, you're gonna feel that, you're gonna feel that on you. You're gonna feel like there's still something missing because you're not confident. Because you're putting everybody before you. And I think it's time to change it up a little bit. Not being selfish, but if you need to be selfish for that right moment because you need to build that confidence up, be selfish. Be selfish. And then you're gonna have that energy, you're gonna have that love to be able to take care of anybody else. Dang it, because I've been through that. If you don't love yourself, you can't take care of anybody else. When you look good, you feel good. When you feel good, you feel damn confident. And when you feel confident, you're not a woman. You can change the world because the fire in you is like nobody else. You crush it with love, spreading love around you. Be grateful, because instead of saying that you need to focus on positive things, which I think you should, but up to a certain point, you need to be grateful for everything you already have. It's something we take it as a habit of having. Having electricity, having the sun, having a roof over your head, all of that we take it as things that naturally just happen. And for you to be able to pay for that, you have a job, you have a business, you have a side job. You have parents, you have families, you have somebody to do it. I'm gonna think about what I want to have before thinking about what I already have. Angry about myself for feeling that way. Come up to a realization that I'm already so much blessed. I have parents that are healthy. I have wonderful relationships with my brothers and sisters. I'm able to have a roof over my head with this Canadian winter. I'm able to invest in myself, to build my business dream. Even if it's hard, even if it's challenging, I can talk to you in the comfort of my home, of my bedroom, with my little babies behind me. By the way, I love Hello Kitty. Yeah. If you need to judge me for it, so be it. You won't take away the love I have for her. I get to share a wonderful message. I get to be inspired by other people. I get to be inspired by my own mom. You need to be grateful for the universe and for God to give all of that. Because the universe is gonna feel frustrated because already giving you a lot of things, even if you're still struggling. So you're not gonna have anything more. Like a parent, a dad, a mom, giving you a gift, a Christmas gift, and you'll be like, yeah. You don't even appreciate it. You're not even being thankful for it. Just tossed aside, like nothing. And then you expect your dad and your mom to take you to that trip that you've been dreaming for all your life. I mean, if I were the mom, I'll be like, you know what, you're gonna stay in a room and that's gonna be it. And if you need to literally talk more, it can be worse. I grew up with an African mom. So I'm telling you, you being frustrated and not being appreciative of what I can give, I can literally magically remove all of it. Watch it happen. Be grateful. Just be grateful for universe and be grateful because you're spending another Christmas. You're gonna see 2020 when other people couldn't be ready. So everything you need to do on your mindset to aim for it, you need to be physically, mentally, emotionally ready for it. But you're never gonna be ready until you actually take actions. Because everything can be changed. No matter what you do, if it doesn't work the first time, it's gonna work at some point. But you need to feel like you're ready to do it. If you need to start up a business, you're gonna pray for it. You're gonna read for it. You're gonna listen to podcasts. You're gonna watch YouTube videos. You're gonna invest in a coach. That's what I call being ready. But you're never gonna be ready until you actually launch something. You need to find that person is to be emotionally, mentally ready for it. Because again, when you come from a point where you feel like you need to be with somebody, that usually is the red flag for me. Give me a little bit of pressure here because I don't want to have to be needed. I want to be wanted. I feel like I want to have somebody, I want to be with somebody, I want to be with somebody. I don't need to be with somebody. Two different things. If you need to invest in people for you to get ready, do it. Because it's a part of being even more confident. Yes, but you need to take action to see if you're ready. And if you're not ready, you go back at it, work on it more, and do it again. As many times as you need to until you get to your dreams. Last thing that I'm gonna share with you is to embrace the power of the body language. You can do so much. You can feel so much confident just having to have a certain posture. I'm gonna give you an example here. If you feel stressed going to an interview, for example, a job interview or anything really important for you, meet investors for your business, you sit down, you pull your shoulders back and you get your head high up high. Sitting down and you practice your interview in a way where you're just gonna feel that energy. Have a posture of confidence. I call it the power posture. So practicing a speech, for example, try to get into those postures. Have a lot more energy. And when you're gonna get in front of the real people you need to talk to, you're gonna feel a bit more confident about it. The power of body languages is so big. And you know, if you want me to have a video, like a complete video on it, having a personal sign for me is not just about having wonderful clothes or beautiful clothes on yourself. It has to be a part of your personal style first, because you're gonna feel confident that way. And the second part is for you to own it. Even if you have a sack of potato bag on yourself, you're still gonna feel confident and people are not gonna see the sack of potato bag. You bring so much confidence that people are gonna feel it. So they're gonna see the clothes being a part of yourself. If it's a part of your true style, people are gonna respect you a lot more for that. And some people are gonna hate you for that as well. It repelling and attracting. You can't please to everybody. That's the way it works. The more you're gonna be quiet, I don't want to be too visible. The more you're gonna have that kind of people on you, because they're gonna use your scarcity mindset to actually feel better themselves. Because it makes them feel better, it makes them look better than you. But from the moment you're gonna feel confident and really feel like yourself, you're gonna repel those people. Being the best version you can possibly be. Or make a choice. Do you want to be that best version? And probably run the risk of repelling some people, even some people you really care about. Or you want to stay like quiet and behind because you might feel attacked if somebody looks at you. Think about it. Bring Hello Kitty with you if you need to. It's not a magic formula for you to feel confident. There's none. If you have any people telling you that you can feel confident just like that, liars. Stay away from them. It takes you to take smaller steps in order to go from a fixed mindset to growth mindset. It takes you each little day, each little steps, each little daily activities. More you're gonna stay stuck, the more difficult it's gonna be for you to quit that mindset. Being and feeling confident is a momentum. The more you're gonna try to do it, the more you're gonna feel confident about doing it. It's a momentum. It takes you to get out of your comfort zone. This is being confident. I have to be grateful for everything that happens in my life, good and bad. The bad things made me learn so much more about me. It gave me such a strength now that I didn't even know I had to get through challenges. It takes you to get through bad moments. It takes you to get through tears. And it takes you to get to those wonderful moments and appreciate them and see yourself transforming little by little, growing. That's what we call confidence. It's a constant evolution. Having a personal style takes a process. It takes for you to get to know you better. When you know yourself better, you already know where to start. If you love Hello Kitty, it's a part of your personal style. Being out of my bubble makes me feel unsafe. But when I realized that I actually used that reason to not get out of my comfort zone, I was like, you know what? When my mind tells me not to do it, actually, I do it now. Listen, do the opposite right away. It's gonna feel bad, it's gonna feel like a torture, you might want to give up, kill everybody. It goes so much against your nature or that scarcity mindset. Your mind is gonna literally target people trying to get you out of your comfort zone. Leave me alone, I hate you. Don't do that. I could talk about it for hours, clearly, as you can see here, but you know, at some point you need to stop. I hope it was honestly super helpful for you. What you're planning to do for 2020? What are your biggest goals for this year? Soon to be 2020, because we're a couple of days away. Share them with me down below in the comment section. Let me know what you like the most about this video. Follow me on Instagram, because this is where I share a bit of my little world, you know. Just follow me there. And subscribe to my channel if you like that type of video, because there's gonna be a mix, so get ready for it. Get ready for the new series that I'm gonna have soon. And I see you for my next video. So until then, hope you had great celebrations. Take that time to rest and reflect and just get ready for 2020, because it's gonna be an awesome year. Le mot de la fin, smile, because it's free and contagious. Bye.